North Carolinians pay taxes to the federal government to send money to North Carolina and other states to spend on things they wouldn't vote to pay for, local, state and local taxes to pay for. That doesn't make a whole bunch of sense in most instances. In some it does if there are multi-state benefits and you need a higher order of government to intervene. We pay large amounts of money for people to idle cropland. We pay large amounts of funds to subsidize ethanol, which dries up food prices and is not only harmful here, but especially in the developing world, where people spend a much higher fraction of their budget on food, and actually on balance probably harms the environment. So we need to have a serious conversation about these things and what can be an orderly consolidation, elimination of things that aren't doing well and we don't need to do, consolidation of programs. We have something like 47 job training programs. It's a rough estimate, they may be off by a little. And there's no reason those shouldn't be consolidated and voucherized, so people who we need retraining for, who need retraining, can get something that's really commercially useful for them in a more effective and more efficient way. When those vets' families at Walter Reed, that were a big scandal a while ago, they couldn't get the help they needed, their families had to access 16 different programs. That wouldn't work in the business world today. We need the government to have one-stop shopping solution centers. We've got 42% of federal civilian employees who are due to retire over the next decade, and we could let that attrition occur and replace half of them with technology and improve services, save hundreds of billions of dollars. Technology executives look at how the federal government handles its IT and say you could save $1 trillion in a decade by streamlining supply centers, by consolidation, by using the advanced business analytics private firms do to identify improper payments, by moving off of immense amounts of custom code into standardized software that businesses use. So we need kind of that substantial transformation, and the president's talking about stabilizing 1/6 of the budget at the extreme elevated levels that from the stimulus and the crisis that's gone up 25% in its baseline and over 80% in when you include the stimulus spending. That's ridiculous. That we don't need that nearly that much spending on that part of the budget.